Hello there, everyone, and hope you're doing super duper great. So my name is Mahmoud Shoaib, and I'm a student of Magic Labs Academy, and I'm part of the storyboard and animatics class, and this is a specialization based on the 2D animation class. So right now, this is my second lecture in our second week of the program. It's a 6 months program and I totally love it. Now I have an assignment to submit, and our simple assignment is to make a thought story with a maximum of 10 panels. I'm supposed to submit this today before 4 p.m. So it's Friday and it's 10:48 a.m. I'm actually working, so I wasn't able to join the physical class, but the good thing is there's a recorded live class. So this is the platform. This is the Magic Lab Learning Media section. And this is basically our program, the software we actually use to access the lectures. So you can actually check out your courses, you can mark your course progress, and you can see how far you've gone. And apologies about the neighbor's dog. It's been really noisy right now, but hopefully it's not going to interrupt me. I'll just have patience and do that. So for the assignment, I'm going to jump to Affinity Designer, and I'll talk through how I intend to approach this. And the good thing is we don't really have much skills yet. So there's not much drawing skills. There's not much, you know, complications. So, and that's how I'm going to actually look at this. I'm not looking at this as I'm trying to be the best thing or compete. No, it's just about my own personal development. And there's something my instructor says, Mr. Obana, very awesome dude. He says, your work is you're trying to just get speed, right? Clarity is a theme, but you're trying to make sure you create your boards be fast out there. Create your boards with speed and try to get corrections as quickly as you can. I believe that's what he was trying to say, and it actually makes a lot of sense, right? Because if you can't really get your boards out there to be critiqued, and basically he says rush to fail. Basically that's it. He said rush to fail, walk fast to get your boards out there, and revisions are going to make your work better. And that's exactly what I'm trying to do. I'm going to think about what I want to do and then try to just put pencil on paper or pencil on the digital software. I'm actually using Affinity Designer right now. I'll just see this. I don't need this one. I'll just close this and click no. I just closed the project I was working on. So let me go ahead and do that. So I'm supposed to create 10 panels. So let's just do that. I'm using Affinity Designer, like I mentioned. So I have a custom preset of HD 1080p resolution. That's 1920 by 1080 pixels. And I'll just click create. Another has created. I'm on the designer persona. So I'll just create a nice little screen and cover this up. Now, also, I really love the flexibility my school, that's Magic Lab Academy, is providing, because I actually work and the classes actually happened when I was working, but it was not a problem because there was a pre-recording and you could watch that pre-recording. Although I really love the live sessions because I could ask questions, but it doesn't mean with the pre-recording I couldn't really watch it and then jot down some questions and then contact the tutor at, you know, where I'm supposed to contact the tutor. I just make sure this is recording, so I'll just go ahead and check like that. Okay, good, it's actually recording, because sometimes I do forget to hit the record button and start recording. So yeah, basically I could ask questions on the GameIC platform, which is a separate platform we actually use to talk to each other with our instructors, and it's actually fun. So now I have this nice little background layer like that. What I'll do is to switch over to the pixel persona. I like using pixel persona for sketching. Basically it's like Photoshop mode right now. So I'll just zoom out a bit till I can see, get the whole picture like that. I think it's totally fine. So I need to create 10 of these and then tell a nice little story with 10 of these boards. And while I was just thinking about what stories to create, I was hungry. So like the story came out as this. So there's this character. He's alone. He's like on a mountaintop and he's trying to prepare dinner. And then this eagle comes over to take his dinner. And as the eagle takes away his dinner, he quickly uses a bow and arrow to take the eagle down, and now he has his dinner and the eagle. And he was frying chicken, rather. So now he's now frying chicken and eagle. So basically, he used a bird to kill two birds, basically something like that. So that's the idea I'm trying to bring out. And remember, it doesn't have to be perfect. We haven't really done so much in the course. Like I said, it's a 6-month course, but this is the second week, and I'll just try to put in some of the things I've learned. And I've learned about shots, a little bit about shots, scene progressions, camera angles, but we haven't really got into much details. So next, I'll just call this layer BG for background. I don't really have to have drawing skills to join the program. And secondly, you don't really need to use Affinity Designer. You can use Photoshop or any other software. You can even use a piece of paper and pen, but just make sure you can scan and sketch and send your assignment as PDF. So this is going to be my background layer, and then I'll create pixels. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we're told to use 10, but we actually use any number. If I can get this in 5 frames, I can still get it and send it like that. So I'll just start sketching here. So I'll hit the brush tool and go over to brushes and see if I can have these. Now this is supposed to go down. I'm just looking for a nice brush with a texture. I think this is fine. This one, 128, it's too large. So I'll just hit this arrow and just drag this down to about 10 pixels. And I'll just start sketching that. Now I'm on this layer. I'll just call this 1. And I'll just start drawing out something here. So we can actually see, hey, yeah, that's totally nice. I like that. I'll just undo that drawing. So yeah. So first I'll have a nice little close-up sketch of the character, kind of like preparing his ingredients. So basically I'll have something like a nice little plate right here. You can see some I'll just put an onion like that, like so. Nice little onion, nothing too fancy out there. And this little like chopping board, and then I'll try to imagine a hand, right? And then there's a knife. Now obviously this is going to help. So I'm just trying to imagine right now in my mind if I'm holding a knife. So I'm going to hold it by the handle. So I'll just draw through. So let's say this is the knife handle first, and then this is our knife edge like that. So very short knife. So if a hand is holding this, let's say our hand is coming from here, then it's going to be covering this section right here. Again, nothing too fancy. So this is my first shot, and I'll just draw this hand again like that, and say he's holding this this knife. And clearly, so we can now see this section here. Good. So I'll use the eraser to just clean up this section. Or I can just leave it and clean up later on, but I just like doing the cleanup as I am working. So I'll just clean up all this section here, because it's going to be weird if you can actually see through this section like that. Just like that. Very simple. Character holding a knife and cutting up some nice veggies. So let's say he sliced this one. And usually you use the other hand to hold the vegetable. So I'll just try to sketch the other hand, like holding this veggie. Nothing too serious here. Just have a little indication, and say we are holding this. And so this is the first part of this onion looking fruit. And then this other part here just falls down because this has been chopped into 2. Right, so our character, let's say this is a little plate or chopping board, and our character has likely like just cut this chopping board like that, and just sliced. I'll just try to make the blade look, have a nice little double edge right here. Alright, so this is actually going to be my first board. So it's a close-up shot, and I could even start doing things like indicating a nice little arrow showing that this actually zooms in on the character, and we could actually see this. And let's just put, do I need a table here? I don't think I need a table, but I'll just indicate that there's a little table over there so that this really looks very nice. All right, good. So I said it's a character, and the character is outside on a mountaintop. So this next shot is going to show what exactly is happening. So I have this nice little fruit. I'll just drag this here. Like, this represents an onion, and we can have some like a carrot just sitting down there like that, and maybe we can have a little tomato around here, or orange, you just get it, just some nice little fruits there, and maybe there's a little salt holder, and maybe there's a little salt here, and some pepper. Just something very simple, nothing too complex. So yeah, so this is my first shot here. So our character is chopping up some fruits, and let's say he has chopped up a little bit more food pieces here, and you can actually see there are smaller parts. When you cut onions, they actually look a bit cylindrical, so I'll just place them here. I don't think that's really clear. These are onions, but this one is like nice and clear. So I'm trying to get part of those things I've learned about, hey, clarity, make your art clear. So that's it, nothing too complex, very simple. So this is my first shot. And the story is, like I said, the story is that he's actually preparing this, and an eagle comes to take away his food. So the next shot is going to show it's going to be a top-down view, sort of a zoomed out view, so that we can see the character. Like, so let's go ahead and just do that. So this is the first shot. I'll turn that off. So in our second shot, this is going to be a zoomed out view, and I'm going to try to draw the entire scene now. And I'm imagining, okay, say our character is sitting down here, right? Our character is sitting down, and then here's the chopping board, and has a little plate, and that's the knife, and those little fruits, and see there's a nice little log of wood here, yeah, like that. He's just sitting down minding his business. And over here we have, let's see, a little rocks down here, something very basic. We have a little tree, and we have smaller trees just to indicate that we have like a moon, I don't know. It's just so here we have a little fire going on here. And then we have a little stand right here. And on this stand, there is some chicken being roasted here. Right? So character's roasting some chicken, and then over here maybe he's his sleeping bag, yep, that's the sleeping unit, and just beside the sleeping bag we have his pack of arrows. And then his bow is right beside it. So I'll just try and indicate that. And I'll just put some clouds like that. There'll be some rocks here. Alright, so in the third shot, I want to emphasize this chicken, like a little bit zoomed in, and then maybe our character is seasoning that chicken, right? So let's do that. So this is our first shot. We can actually see our character preparing stuff, but then we realize he's outside, and there's some chicken here. Has bow and arrow, maybe a little adventurous guy. Nothing's wrong with him. So in the next one, let's actually show a close-up shot of that chicken being seasoned. So here I'll just try to imagine my hand actually, you know, try like putting some pepper, spraying some pepper. So it's let's start drawing the pepper like that, and then I'll draw the hand kind of like pouring the pepper. And I just want to make this clear as much as I can. All right, so I'll just indicate some movement. And I'll just show that little chicken right there being grilled. Now I might need to zoom out a little bit, so I'll select these and use the transform tool. I'll just drag this out a little bit like that, and I think I like it there. So I'll hit escape to deselect this, and I'll just keep on drawing. So I'll hit the brush tool and just keep drawing that. So actually notice I've lost information. Let's see where I am. So I don't want to continue drawing there. Let me delete this. I think it's on our third scene here. So I'll call this 2, and each time I create the scene, I'm going to lock this. So lock, go over here and lock, and good. So I know I'm on number 3. So I'll set 3, hit enter, so I don't accidentally draw on 1 and 2. So I'll just put it here just so that you can map. And you know, we have that little rod that goes through here. You know, it kind of like goes out. So this actually stays. Yeah, and then we're actually spraying some of that on that chicken. You can see some of that fire. Just a little bit of that flame, nothing too serious. And we have a little bit of that log of wood. Alright, so we can see where our character is seasoning his chicken. Right, so let's see what we have all true. So we have frame one, cutting up frame two. I can see the whole thing. Frame three is actually seasoning that chicken. Now on frame four, this is where I'll try to introduce the hawk flying. So just a hawk flying at night. So this, I'm trying to create the camera, and it's going to be like from below. So I'll just try to eyeball this, and let's just try and do a nice little hawk flying at night like that. And let's emphasize the legs. So I'll just try to make this dark. It's just flying at night, and I like to extend the wings to make him look really massive and majestic. So the hawk's just flying there, you know. And we can have indicate some of these trees just to show that, hey, we have this hawk flying. Let's make some of this small like that. And I'll just indicate this, just show a nice little moon and maybe a nice little cloud. This is terrible. I'm actually laughing at my own art, but I'll just put it there. So we have this hawk flying, right? And then let's say the hawk spots something cooking. So here, this is going to be a crazy one. So I'm going to call this four, and I'll call this five. So I'll just turn it off now. So this is where it's going to get tricky, because I want to show the hawk spotting the chicken. So I'm going to draw the hawk. How do we draw a hawk spotting chicken, for God's sake? I don't know. But I think I need to okay, let's go through what we have. Maybe I'll get an idea. First, we're preparing, and secondly, the whole thing. Thirdly, we're marinating that guy. Then we have a hawk flying over, and then the hawk sees. So I'm going to indicate, I think I should think drawing. If it doesn't work, I will always erase it, think draw. And what I'll do is say, okay, let's say the hawk is flying above here like that. So this is a hawk eye view. And maybe we're seeing this from the top down, right? So this is the area where our character is. So let's say it's a mountain area like that. And to indicate this is a top down, I'll just create those trees like that. So this is our character, actually, you know, that log of wood. He's sitting down there. There's the little chicken that's flying. He's cooking, right? So we can't really see the character, but we can actually have an indication. Like someone sitting there. And then remember, we have his little bed space. So we'll just put that there. I think it's too close to the fire, so let's erase that. So I'll go back to the brush tool, and I'll just put the bed space a little bit further away here. So this is where he's sleeping. Then we have the little arrow, and then we have that bow and arrow just lying down there. And I could just indicate, like, hey, the hawk is actually flying over. And I think there is a frame. I'll explain to you what I mean. There's a frame I'm actually missing here, and that frame is really going to make this interesting. So these are trees like that. I'll just try to indicate some of the branches around. So these are trees, and this is the edge like that. And then let's not forget to put the fire underneath. Just a little bit of fire. And he's sitting on, I believe I said he's sitting on a log of wood. So we really need to show that log of wood. So the frame I'm missing is when the hawk spots the chicken, right? So I think what I can do is to draw the eye of the hawk and then draw that chicken. So if this is frame four, okay, good. I think I, so hawk flying, then hawk is now going after the chicken. So hawk flying, so I'll need the hawk spots. So I'll hit this five. I think I can name them, but no problem. So this is where the hawk spots the chicken. So I'll just draw a real close-up shot of the hawk's head. So I'll just do this and then draw the eye and make the eye quite big. And seriously, I don't know what a hawk looks like, so I'll just try to So I'm trying to split the frame into two, and this hawk is just there, and what I'm trying to do is just indicate that he has actually seen that. So I'll just draw another little line like that. And just to show that that hawk has seen that chicken that's been roasted there. I'll just draw this. And I believe the best way, instead of splitting that, what I can do is I'll just draw this over here. And instead of doing this diagonal line, I could like do a cone that indicates, hey, there's a focus here. So this line is going to look a bit deceptive. So I'll just clean up this line. And what I'll do is to just draw a cone of vision. So I'll go back to my pencil tool and draw a nice little cone like that. And this will just indicate that, hey, this hawk has actually seen this. So I believe this now makes sense, because if he's flying here, he's just flying minding his business. Now he sees chicken. Now he's going for it. And so on the, I'll call this six. So on the seventh frame, I'm going to show the action has already happened. And it happened so fast. So to show that action happening, I'm going to draw the fireplace is going to be my focus. And let me just draw think. So let's add a, and then I haven't saved my project, so I'll just hit Control S. And I'll just call that assignment 01 and hit save. So that's assignment 01, and I'll just go up here. So he's going in for the kill, he's seen it, he's going in for the kill, and now let's indicate the kill has happened already. So to indicate that, I'll just draw the hawk. Okay, let's start with the fireplace, and everything has, you know, being destroyed, so it's a nice little close-up shot that just shows that fireplace thing just going off. So this part has moved a bit away, and then this metal has actually moved, the one used to hold the thing, and then we have this piece of wood that has left its position, and then we have some of that wood fire here. So we have some fire splinters all around. This is moving, this has shifted, this has moved, and now we need to indicate a swoopy movement, like something like that. And then we'll actually have that hawk taking off, and then we need to draw the legs and then show some of that claw. And then the eagle just looking away like, I just nicked your dinner. And then we'll have some of that chicken showing like that. So I'll just try to indicate. All right, so we have our fireplace. So this has been detached. So we'll just put some of that. These are our speed lines. Alright, so our eagle has swooped the chicken and is going away. So our character is going to have a very shocking reaction. But let's see if we have actually following. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is our 7th frame. Let's see, 7. And this time around we'll have a zoomed in expression on the character's face. Like, what the hell just happened? Right, so here I'm going to have a very close-up shot of the character's face, or close-up 7, and I'll just draw his face right now at the center. Like dude, what the, all that time I've been sitting here, and so the mouth is going to be open. I'll just indicate a little nose, and the eye is going to be like so wide. And then the brow is going to be like, ha. Huh. Like, wow. So we'll draw a character, and he's surprised, like, I think I can make it more dramatic if the hands are on the head, right? So it's like shock, like, ah, damn. So what I'll do is to, let's make a selection around this drawing. And I'll try to drag this down a bit to have space for the hands, and I'll hit the escape key. So I'll go back to this layer and try to draw the hands on the head. So I'll just try to, let's get back to the brush tool, and let's go back to not 5, I think we're on 8. So let's just draw his hand on his head like let's draw this other hand. Like that. So that means if we draw through the head, we can actually see through. So I like drawing through just to indicate that. And since we're zoomed in, we can add a little bit of, you know, things like that, but I'll just keep it right here like that. Alright, so this is our shock pose. I think adding the hands on the head is actually going to go a long way and then tell us like, damn, this is this happened. So now that that has happened, so what's the story? Now I have two more frames. So on this frame, I'm going to show the character trying to pick up his bow and arrow. Now, see, I'm trying to ask myself a question. Can I have multiple frames in one frame? And the answer is, I think that's a no-no. But let me just show what's happening here. So I have the character, and he's now running. And he's just running to... So nothing too complex. And then he picks up the bow and arrow. So I'm just going to indicate what's happening here. I'm just going to draw the hand. No, I don't think this is really helpful. So let's say he has picked it up already. So he's running to pick up his bow and arrow. So I'll just clean this. Or, I don't think this is good storytelling. So I'll just indicate that the character turned his head. And then once he turns his head, so let's create one here. I'm just going to say 9. So now our character is running. But before he's shocked, okay, good, our character is shocked. And then he turns his head. So 9 is empty. He's shocked, right from the shock, turns his head. So I'll just go ahead and draw this. So I'm going to draw a profile view. So he just turns his head like that. Just draw his hair. So he turns his head to look at his bow and arrow. So I'll just draw this here and then drag it over here. So that's why he's turning his head, because he remembers, hey, I have my bow and arrows over there. So I'll just draw a nice little, oh, thank you. It added the pixel layer I didn't add. And where did I stop? Okay, running. Okay, good. So when he sees the bow and arrow, I'm on pixel 9. So let's see our little arrow case here. And draw this arrow. Draw this other arrow like that. And then sees his bow lying there. Oops, thank you, Alex. Just draw this. Yeah, I'm not really worried about the head. We can always fix the head. I personally have a weird head shape, so yeah, that's cool. So he sees his bow and arrow. Now he runs to pick it up. I think it makes more sense then. So he runs. So I think I can make this easy, right? I could draw, instead of showing that he just sees the bow and arrow. So if he sees the bow and arrow, obviously he's going to pick it up. But to emphasize that, it's super fast. So let's just see this. I'll do this here. So I might use this, I might erase this. So I'll just draw that he's holding it. And then he's holding like an arrow on his hand. So already our eagle, you know, has begun to go away. So here's the eagle, and there's the little helpless dinner, helpless delicious dinner right there. Going away. So just draw a line here. I think I'm on 10 already. So unfortunate. I think I'll go ahead. So I'll just add 11 here. So this part, he's going to take aim. And to really show that he scored the target, let's do something like this. Let's say, so I'm on 11. Let's do some, this is a close-up shot, like that. So this arm is holding the arrow, like that, the bow. And this is his arm. And there's our little bird. It's going away, and then a little silhouette of that chicken because it's getting smaller. And let's see, our character has released this arrow. So let's just draw this line and indicate it's a bit wobbly like that. And this arm, let's indicate that he has released that arrow. So let's just say he just released that arrow, and it's actually, you know, gone here, and it has hit this bird. So we'll just indicate some motion. In fact, I'm trying to show that it has actually hit the bird. So that's it. So I think that's that makes a little sense. I hope it's clear. I'm gonna get scolded. So he runs, picks up the bow and arrow, sees the bow and arrow, picks it up and is running, targets, hit the bird, and then on 12 we're gonna have the initial setting again, but now he's going to have two birds, an eagle and the chicken. So we're actually back to square one. So I'll just look at my initial drawing and turn in layer that's on off. So we'll go back to this drawing here, frame two. And now we're going to have the chicken and the eagle. Just trying to make it a bit smaller than the chicken, but have a nice little flame. So now the I think the bed is going to be there. Let's just put the bed back there. And because let's say he kind of like ran around there, we'll have a little arrow case over here and his little log of wood, and he's just sitting down. Just waiting for everything to be done. And let's just indicate that he's using a little stick to poke his new eagle soup. Now we can just draw the arrow, the bow over here. Nothing too fancy like that. Alright, I think basically that should go a long way. We have a little rock here. And there's that little table. And we just put the table here instead of putting it over there. So I'll just undo that sketch and just put that little pan that has that table where he had his veggies initially created. And there, I think I went a little bit overboard. I don't think it's gonna get me shot or anything. So this is the entire storyboard. It looks all messy, but yeah, looks cool. So let's go over it and see. Again, don't really beat yourself. I'm not going to really beat myself if I don't get this correct. So I made out 12. So I'll just delete all these. So I'll hold shift and delete these ones. And I'll just save that as assignment 01. And let's go over that and see what's happening. So if I click this, obviously someone's cutting something. Then this person cutting stuff. He's outside. We can see trees. He's roasting some chicken. He's an adventurer. We can actually see his little bow and arrow. That's totally fine. Then next, oh, he's garnishing that chicken. And we have this little eagle, hungry, flying around. And eagle sees chicken. Then, after eagle sees chicken, eagle begins to swoop in for the grab. Eagle grabs chicken, causing chaos. Then man gets shocked. Then man realizes I have a bow and arrow. Then man takes picks up and runs. Then man takes a lucky shot and gets the creature. And now man has two sets of dinner. Totally awesome. So how do I convert this to a PDF file? Because if I do this, I'm going to have, I think I want to have the background. So I'm going to see how I can export each frame separately. And then once I have them separately, I can convert everything into a single PDF file. So let's start with the first one. Now you can actually see I have the background and these guys separated. So this is going to be a very boring process. I'll select these two. So just one, two, and hit shift and control like that. I'm going to go to file, export. So I'm going to export it as one PNG. Or should I export each one as a PDF separately? So if I export each one as a separate PDF, I'm going to have 10 PDF files. But if I export everything as one PDF file, okay, I know what to do. I export everything as a PNG, then use the other Affinity publisher to create a PDF file of the assignment and submit. But now I'm going to export the selection only. So I'm going to hit export. And I'll put this in a proper folder. So let me go to my new volume D. So I'm going to call this folder storyboards. Storyboarding. And I'll just call this 01 because it's the first one I'm exporting. So now that I've done 01, let's hit that and let's export 02. So I'll hit 2, turn off 1. So I'm now exporting 2 on the background. So the background is not selecting. I believe I should hold Control and select this one. So let's see, maybe I don't need to actually deselect it. So hit this. All right, good. So I'll export. So go to File, Export, Selection Only. So I'm exporting two now. So I go to Export, and I'll call this 02. So deselect this, turn on three, select three, and the background. So I'll just do that. So I'll go to File, Export, PNG, Export, three. So I'll go to four, turn off three, go to four, select the background. Good. I think there's a shortcut key to export, but I'll just keep using this tool. So I'll just say selection only, export. So this is going to be 04. Like so. So let's go to the fifth one. Turn this on. Make sure I select the background as well. So I'm going to go to File, Export, Selection Only, Export. I'll call this 05. We're almost done, don't worry. I'll just move up, select 6. 6, and let's not forget the background, so I'll turn this on. So 6 and the background, go to File, Export, 06, like that, select 7, go to Export, so I'll go to File, Export, Selection Only, 7. I know it's the most boring thing. We're almost done. So I'll go to 8 now. I need to turn off 7, go to 8. Okay, we have both selected now. So go to File, Export. I think there should be a script that does this. So I'll just call this 8, and I'll move over here, select this one, select this one, that's 9, so I'll hit Control and select this, and 9, so I'll go to File, Export, and PNG, so I'll go to Export. I'll call this 9, and I'll go here, go to 10, yep, so I'll go to File, Export, make sure this is selection only, this is 10. And we'll select the last one. So I hit Control and hit this. I'll get rid of this. Go to File, Export. So this is 11. And this is 12. So I went a little bit overboard, but I think it's going to be fine. So I'll go to File, Export, PNG, Selection Only, and hit Export. So this is 12. So let's go to that folder where we have these exports. I believe I called it It's in my storyboarding. Yeah, good. Called it storyboarding. And we have these 12 frames. Let's just go through them quickly. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now, I believe here I could actually add something here to indicate that this guy got hit. So I'll go back to 11. I'll delete 11 here because I won't really indicate that he actually hit that bird. So I'll go to 11 and do a little bit of, although this is a storyboard, this is not a comic. So I'll just add it here to indicate that that actually happened. Like pow, you see some of that feather effect there like that. So I'll just add that to show that the guy got hit. And again, if it got hit, it's going to release the it's going to release this chicken it's holding. So I'll just show that the chicken has now been detached from the eagle like that, and it's falling down due to gravity. So I'll go back to my brush and I'll just draw a reverse chicken falling down like that. Yeah, I believe this makes more, this helps to describe what's happening there. So the bird silhouette, sorry eagle, you got hit. So the eagle got hit and it released the bird, just like that. I think this is a better frame 11, but I'm not going to beat myself about it. So I'll just drag this down. Make sure I hit the camera, hit you guys. Sorry. So I'll just hold control, hit this. And so that's 11. So I hit control. I'll just go to file export. Selection only. So this is going to be 11 now. So save. So now that I have all these, I'm going to use the Affinity Publisher so I can publish all those PNG images as a PDF. So this is also part of that Affinity Designer suit. I'll just have a biscuit while it's loading. Right, cool. So we have Affinity Publisher loaded. And the cool thing is if you have a publisher, you can open up Designer. We can switch to Designer Persona or Photo Persona, but I'll go back to the Publisher Persona. So I'll go to File, New. What I'll do is to use a HD resolution. So this is going to be the same size I used to create. So it's a full HD 16:9. So I'll hit create. And what I'll do is just bring in each of my everything I created. I'll just bring them in and then place them and make sure they are on each board like that. So I'm just going to go to file, place. And I need to find the location where I have that art. We call it storyboarding. Okay, so this is the first one. One. So I'll place it here. And you can see the cool thing, it's roughly the same size as our design. So we always just place it here, like that. And the cool thing with this is you can actually have, let's do page two. Let's open up the navigator and, so I'll just double click page two. And we could use a picture frame tool and place that here and then have every frame, but I'll just go to file place and Control Shift M. So I'll just use the shortcut key to make things easier a bit. So you can see that. So let's go to page three. So there's a Control Shift M. I believe it was Control Shift M. Yeah, it was Control Shift and the letter M. So three, let's quickly place three. This is my best scene, the garnishing. Garnish that tasty chicken. So on scene four, Control Shift M. Four. Let's go to page five, Control Shift M. This is five. Let's place that over here. So let's go to page six, Control Shift M. Six. See, it's just a monotonous process. Let's try this here. Let's go to seven, Control Shift M. Am I on seven? Yeah, I need to drag it down a bit and place it here. So this is seven. So let's go to eight. I think I did the wrong thing, Control Shift M. This is six, this is seven, so on eight. Okay, so what happened? Because I can't see any of my works. I need to go to all documents. Okay, good. So this is eight. I must have pressed something by mistake, I guess. So let's go to board. Nine. So nine, we're left with three more. Let's place it here. So let's go to board 10. Control Shift and M. This is 10. Let's place it over here. I think that's fine. So now we're out of boards. Panic mode. So I need to create a page here. And how do I do that? I think I can go to document and go to add page and go to document and go to add page again. So I have two more pages. So 11, Control Shift M. So it's 11. I just hit open and place that here. And then finally on 12, Control Shift and M. I'll just hit that last frame where he's just happy sitting down. Now, I think I can add something on frame 12 to make it better. Really sorry. Sometimes you just see things you can do. If I go to 12, and I'm 11, I'm on 12, I can make this more interesting, show he's happy. If I make, let me just show you what I mean. If I do this, like, right, like he's whistling, and you know, like that. So I'll use this one. I'll call that 13, but I'll make sure that it's what I'm going to place on 12. So I'll just hit this. All right, good. So I'll export the selection. So I'll call that 13 in place of 12. I just added that music real quick. So I'll go back to my frame 12 and delete that, and then Control Shift M to place our new image as 13. I'll just open this guy and place it right here like that. So now you see we have a nice little frame with music, and we just use that there. And so editing this last frame, I just added that music thing. So, but you see, I spent roughly an hour. Let's look at the Camtasia time here. And this is it. So yeah, roughly an hour trying to explain and, you know, describe what I was doing. If I wasn't talking, I would have maybe done this in like 40 minutes or even less. But the important thing to know is that everything I just did could be canceled. Like, it could be really criticized. And my instructor could say, hey, you know what, you change this. Or he could say, hey, you know, redo everything again. This is scrap, right? So don't really take it too personal when you're being critiqued. As fast as you can, create your storyboards. And as soon as you get updates or critique, you just keep making corrections. It will be a point where you would automatically learn to just create a very good storyboard because you've done a lot of boards and have a lot of corrections. So take critiques positively. Don't feel bad. My work hasn't been critiqued yet. If it is, I'll actually tell you guys, hey, look, my work was critiqued and this is what I was told to do. This was how I was supposed to improve my work. So simple, nothing too complicated. So what I'll do last is to convert everything to a PDF. Now that I've used, I'm using Affinity Publisher, I'll just make everything a PDF. It's going to be straight up, straightforward. It's just going to be a 12 page PDF. So I'll just go to File and say Export. And this is a PDF. It says PDF High Quality Digital. The raster DPI, I'll set this to 400 because I want this to be high. And the area is going to be all pages. And yeah, I'll just hit Export. And I'll export that to that same storyboard. Now I'll just call this Assignment 1. I'll just put my name and say Mamoose_assignment_01, like that. Mamoose assignment 01. Simple. So that's my assignment 01, and it's a PDF. And it's actually going to preview the item when it has exported it. Now, in case Affinity Publisher is what you can use to create a full PDF document. You can also use it to edit PDF documents, and it's part of the Affinity Designer suite. So let's see what we have here. So we have, and next time I think I'm going to use a very dark ink instead of using this sketchy outline, or maybe I'll just edit this. And this is the that's the outcome. Some of them might not be clear, but whew, look at that chicken going away. Shocked, looks at the arrow, grabs it and run. Shoots, takes down the bird. We can actually see the chicken falling off. And then finally, he's having a very nice evening where he has captured two birds with one arrow, I guess, something like that. So peace. So what I'll do next is to upload that assignment on my platform. So I'm just going to write a title for the submission. I'm just going to say assignment 01 submission. I believe I have messed up the spelling of assignment. There is no... Okay, what's wrong? I can't spell assignment again. That's cool. Okay, thank you. I'll just say regards, and I'll choose a file. So it's going to be that, let me just jump over to that storyboarding folder where I have storyboarding. There you go. And this is the assignment, the one we converted to PDF. So I'll just upload that and hit submit assignment. All right, good. I believe, yeah, it says your assignment 01 submission. So I think it's here. So, and then they can actually download it. That's cool. I'll just hit continue lesson. And that's it. Oh, cool. So we have another class by 5 p.m. today. And this is how, it's actually super cool, right? So we can use the web browser or we could use Zoom. If my web browser doesn't work, I'll just use Zoom just to make sure everything is totally fine. So, peace.